Hi, I'm Turbo Tim from ZZPerformance. I'm here to make a short video on how easy a remote tune from us is. First, you'll receive the box. This box will have the laptop, the HP Tuner's interface in it. Here's the interface, laptop, the charger, your packing slip, and your prepaid return label. Don't need the box anymore. Okay, now moving on to the laptop and interface. Let's open the interface. This is the newer MPVI2, the most common one that you'll use with us. There is an MPVI1, it's just larger, functions exactly the same. So you have the interface itself and the cord. Now let's move on to going into the car. Now that we're in the car, we have our laptop fully charged, we have our interface and our cord. First step is locating your OBD2 port. On this car, it's right here. This customer car has an OBD2 port already plugged in, so just unplug that, move it aside, plug the interface in. Now you take your cord, unravel your cord, plug it into the interface, and then into the laptop. Now, powering on the laptop. Open it, power it on. Now it's time to use the editing software. That is a little silver wrench at the bottom, or if you go to Programs and you go to HP Tuners and HP Tuners Editor, click that. It takes a couple seconds to open. Now that your cords are completely plugged in, interface plugged in, everything's ready to go, now it's time to power on the car. So, this car actually has a key, so you're going to take the key and you're going to click it 2 clicks forward to on, not start, just to on. On a push button start car, you will hold the button on until the gauges light up, which is usually about 4 to 5 seconds. Okay, now you go back to your editing software. At the very top, there is the read vehicle button. You will click that once. Go to the gather info, click that. What that does is that reads the modules on the car that HP Tuners allows you to edit. If you have a vehicle with a fuel computer, it is called an FSCM. You will select do not read for that. However, if you have an automatic transmission vehicle like this car here, you will leave the ECM and the TCM set to read entire, which is a default setting. And then you will click read. Now the amount of time this takes varies from car to car and how many modules you're reading. So it can take between 2 minutes and 6 minutes on average. Now you just wait. Now that the interface has completely read all the modules on this vehicle, we're going to save it as your name, stock, and then save it to, let's say, the desktop of the computer just for ease of finding it. Now the HP Tuners has your file open on it. Now you need to email me or your tuner that file. So you'll go to your email address, you'll click new email, however your email works on that. Now you need to select the correct person to send this to. For example, myself, Tim@ZZPerformance, Matt@ZZPerformance, or Alan.M@ZZPerformance. What I generally like is the subject put like ZZP number sign in your order number. You know, I'll just put 12345 on here and then click attach, browse this computer, go to the desktop, select the file, then it attaches and you just click send. Now that you've emailed this file, and let's say we emailed you that modified file back, you'll go to your email address, you will download the file, save it to the desktop. We'll usually call it something like, you know, your last name A or B, depending on how many revisions we've had. And then you will open that file. Just select file in the editor, open, and now you're ready to flash the car. Take the key or your push button start, put it to ignition on once again. Now that the file is open, you'll click write vehicle. Now your little window shows here that's asking about license options. Click the button, show license options. Now it pops up the box that says, do not license, specific vehicle license, or unlimited. You will select specific. That looks at this car's VIN number and it matches the file with the car, and this burns, in this case, 2 credits. Are you sure? Yes. Now your vehicle writer box shows up. Since this file has a different engine and transmission flash, you will leave both of these at write calibration. Okay, now just for a quick recap. At this point, you have read your PCM file, sent it to ZZPerformance, we've modified it, emailed it back to you, and you just wrote that modified file to the car. At this point, you just have a mail order tune, as you would hear online. The cool part about the ZZP remote tune is that ours is more than that. Now what you will do is you will start the car, you will enable the scanner, and you will drive the car, and you will make a nice long scan for us. That lets us adjust fuel trim, shift points, you know, wide open throttle, fueling and timing, among many other things. That's what makes this a good experience. Like, your car will be tuned specifically for your mods, your fuel. That really makes it a perfect tune, not just a mail order tune. I'll walk you through how to use a scanner. So you read and wrote the PCM, close that window. You can minimize or close the editor. Now you open the scanning software, which is a little yellow lightning bolt, which is the HP Tuner scanner. Now that the program is open, now it's very important that we select the correct channels, which are the sensors that we are recording in the scan. So you go here to the left, you click the recent channel configs. You will select open channel config. Now you will locate the channel that we generally email you, which I would say save it to the desktop. Just select that, and then you will click open. Now that fills your left bar here of all your channels and sensors that you're reading. Now it's time to start the car. Okay, we'll start the car. And then all you have to do is click the start scanning button at the top, the little red record button. At this point, the engine's up to full running temperature, and all you have to do is just take the car for a drive. Longer the better. I mean, you could literally send us a 30-minute scan and it's completely fine. We can scroll through it. We will find anything that we want, look at, you know, whatever we would like, and make adjustments based on that. Let's say I took this for a drive and I'm done and I'm ready to save this log. Go to the top, select stop scanning. Now you select save log file as, save it as your last name, one, let's say, since this is the first drive. Click save. Just like you sent us your file originally, you'll email us that scan. And from that scan, we'll make adjustments. We'll send you another file, and then you just write the new file to the car again, make another scan, send it to us, and do it until the car is perfect. Until your tuner says they're completely happy and there's nothing else that needs to be done, and then you can return your interface and laptop if you would like. Okay, now that the flashing is done, the scanning is done, now it's time to return your interface and laptop if you want. The interface in the box, laptop in the box, along with the interface and the charger. You have this envelope right here. This has your prepaid return label in it. Make sure to use very good packing material so the laptop or interface is not damaged. Close the box, slap this label on it, and give it to any, you know, USPS or UPS postal service place, depending on the label we send you. Okay, one thing I do want to say is it is a great idea to keep the interface and laptop, at least the interface, because this interface is licensed to your vehicle now. So that means it could have between $100 in credits or $400 in credits to tune your specific vehicle that you would have to purchase again if you wanted to make a tune update. Like if you add new mods and you need to revise the file, which we can do, but you will need an interface to do that. So I highly recommend at least keeping the interface. and or the laptop. Again, my name is Turbo Tim from ZZPerformance. Thank you for watching.